inside. Wake every morning, cold winds cover me. Because all I got is close to what could be. If you could see the light shining from me, if you could see the light shine out where you be.
Traps are set, let's see what we get.
I was just about to cast and to do a little video, but my mate Les here, he's just out of place. Look at that. Hold her up, Les. That ain't a bad little place as well, look. There's some girth on that. It's a thick old fish, isn't it?
Yeah,
he's first ever place. And yeah, it's not because he couldn't catch them, it's because he didn't want to catch them. Isn't that right, Les?
Yep.
He didn't actually go out and target, so he's come out for the first time ever, target in place, and he's banged one out, isn't it?
Yep. There you go, first ever place using a pulley dropper, bit of lug, tip of squid.
Well, guys, it's sun's just fading now. It's absolutely freezing now. I am cold. It's gonna warm up. We're catching a few fish. I've just had another one, only about a pound and a half. Les is walking around down there now like he's cocking a walk because he's caught a fish and he caught a place. Absolutely awesome, made up for him. Hopefully now he can just get out there and improve on the size. That's what it's all about now. It wasn't about catching it, it was about improving on the size now. So hopefully he does it. Yeah, there's been a spotted caught down the other end. Martin Larkin had a spotted there of 5 pound 8 ounce. Really good fish. I'm surprised there haven't been a few more had out this boat now, to be fair. But time to get another couple of baits going. I just brought this one, obviously I had this one here in with a fish on. I think I'm gonna chuck out one more place bait, and then I'm gonna have to go over to the ray bait, I think, and try and catch myself a spotted. I was gonna start off with onto the spotties now really, but Rob was down the other end there and he's just finished his fishing, so he'd come up and give me some rag that he dug the other day. No one's had rag all day, or most of the lads down here hadn't had rag all day, just because of the little influx in the fishing at the minute. People's been in and buying it all up, so hopefully that is a big old rag that's going to catch me a big old place. I've had a few out, I think I've had 8 or 9 now. If I can just improve on the size now rather than quantity, I'll be absolutely overjoyed. He's yes, Les, look, he's walking around like he's on a bag of air now. Absolutely loves it. No better feeling at all. But we'll get a bait in the water, try again. That's all we can do.
Yeah, I was just wrapping my gear up. I've put everything away now, so this one's on the phone, sadly. But Lewis has got himself a fish on. Les has gone down there to land it. Hopefully it's something half decent. It's a ray. And Les is running. Hey, hey, hey. Nice one, Lou. He's actually, we're all here for the place. Lewis actually come down and he's, you're actually targeting these, aren't you?
Yeah, I've had a little go on the place, but no joy, so I went back to the ray now, mate.
And he's got himself a spotted ray. Kind of wishing I didn't pack my rods up now, but there you are, such is life. Look at that.
So your session's worthwhile now, yeah, boy?
Melvin, no use, bro.
What was he had on, Lou?
He was on Bluey, mate, that one.
Yeah, old favourite Bluey.
Yeah, some what rig? Of it. Just on a poly.
Happy days. Bang it out as far as you can get him. Really? And there it is, look.
Happy with that one.
Lovely little spotty. Handsome. Get a couple of pictures now and send him back, eh?
Yeah, that's the one, mate.
Right, we've had a quick wait. He was 4.11, wasn't he?
4.11.
£4.11. Have you had any before?
That's first spotted.
First spotted?
First spotted.
See, Les, I'm first again. Oh, loves it. Oh, loves it. Get as much enjoyment of him catching it and as I do myself. Yeah, absolutely stunning little fish. First fish at a PB, £4.11.
Yeah.
Absolutely brilliant. Just nice now to watch him go back alive. Have you got, oh, you haven't got no boots on, have you?
No.
Do you want to hold the camera then and I'll let him go for you? Make sure I don't get too wet. He will turn over in a sec and he will go. He hasn't been out of water in more than a minute and a half. Where's my light? It's off, isn't it? There he is. There he is. Look at that lot. Yeah, he's sat there. But he's going. Yeah, he's off. Nice one, Lou! And so does another adventure. I'm packing my gear up now and I'm off. Out of here.
Right, guys. While I was out fishing yesterday, I got asked a question on Facebook and how you process the flatfish that I'm catching. Obviously, this is the fish. What I've done last night, I come home, clean them all up. I've taken the guts out. I don't like leaving them too long with the guts in. I've taken the guts out and I put them in a tray in the fridge. And if you can see, that fish has gone. He's gone a bit slimy there, but he's gone pretty solid. Rigor mortis has set in and the meat stiffens up a little bit. I don't know if you've noticed, if a few of you have actually filleted fish before and you do it on the mark, you know, if you've got a fire going, a barbecue going or whatever, and then you think, oh, I'll have a couple of mackerel or pollock whiting, whatever it is, and the meat's really, really soft and it's hard to fillet. Once the fish has settled and rested a little bit, it's absolutely perfect for filleting. So what I'm going to do is my best attempt at filleting a couple of these plays. For me son to have this evening. The rest are going to go down the street to a neighbour a couple of doors down who I'm sure will appreciate a nice bit of place for tea. Now, probably the most important thing when filleting a fish is having a good knife. I unfortunately haven't got the fillet knife I had as broke. So I've got an old one here and what I've got is a sharpening tool. This is an AccuSharp. You can buy these from a few tackle shops, if not fishmongers or somewhere like that. Or a fish chandlery, and all you do is simply run it through the little groove. Well, guys, got my station set up now. What I've done is I've put a towel down. These fish are quite slimy, and when I put them on the kitchen worktop, I'll be fighting for ages trying to keep it still. Normally, if I was on a boat or I was in a proper filleting station, there'd be a little spike out of the worktop where I could put the head onto, and then it would hold the fish in place while I was doing it. As I don't want to put screws into the wife's worktop, I've put a towel down, so let's go for it. Right, guys, we'll start off with this little one. Now, what I've already done is I've cut just from just under that fin back to just under that fin, straight across on the darker side. And then if you get your knife in from here, behind the guts, and then pull out, all the guts will come out. And then you just come up and cut the guts off. That is how you prepare a fish as soon as you get home from fishing. But then obviously once you've let it rest and sit there, then you'll move on to this stage. So always remember just to take the guts out first. And what I'm going to do is from the corner of that cut, up and around, I'm going to move the knife up just to take it right up around the head. I'm not going to go as far as to cut into the backbone. There's no need for that. And from there, there's a line. I'll pick this fish up again so you can see. There's a line that goes down here. Now what I'm going to do is direct from that line from the bottom, I'm going to carry that on straight. So it's going to take me to the corner of my cut there. I'm going to go into there, just in far enough to where I can feel the backbone of the fish. So here we go. And just take it right down. Maybe just give it one little go just to make sure it's through. So now that is right through to the backbone there. Now from there, I stick my knife in and just feel just to the side of the backbone of the side that I'm cutting, just with the tip of the knife, and come in. Up the top here is normally a little bit harder just because there's a couple more bones in there, and normally you've got to go through one or two just to get into it. And then what you do is you hold the knife almost flat to the fish, so it's just above the flesh on the other side, and then run it nice and gently with not too much pressure against the spine of the fish, well, not the spine of the fish, the bones of the fish, and then just come back. And there's no rush, there's no panic. Don't worry about if you miss a little bit of meat, but just run along that bone and glide it across the top of the bone, and you'll come right in between the bone and the meat there. Always watch your fingers while you're doing it as well. But as you can see now, that is most of the way off. On these fish, when it gets towards the fins on the outside here, there's not really a lot of meat to them. So that one there has come right across now. All I'm going to do is simply cut right along at this edge. It's a bit of a slippery one. And there we have a boneless fillet of plaice, completely boneless. Not a single bone in that fillet. And there's one quarter of that fish. So what I'll do, get myself a plate, and that one's going on there. Then from there, just slightly adjust the fish so I can get down the other side. So I'll turn the knife this way now, and again, keep it low, keep it quite low, and feel the spine of the fish. Again, up the top there, there's a couple of small bones, there they go. And then just run that knife down there. There's a couple of bones gone. And just keep it going the same. And up. And there, another little fillet. Perfect eating fillet. Not a single bone in it. This bit, if you can see, this bit is still there. Obviously, I didn't take it. If you come to doing a place and try it, have a look at it, and if you can keep that knife flat right in, away and around, there is a couple of small bones in there, but this is literally, it's wafer thin, there's nothing really in this section here, so it's not worth the aggro of trying and trying and trying to take that one there off. Now I'm going to turn the fish over, obviously finish me cut on that side there, and then come down this side again, into the same. Now again, I can see a line right up the centre, and then it just kicks off. I'm going to carry that line straight up and come down. Just like that. I can feel the spine there, and it's just on this side of the fillet. So what I'm going to do this side first. Just take it through there. Keep the knife as flat as you can. And keep your fingers out of the way of the knife, the blade. with a decent knife and a bit of practice, this really is an easy task. Again, I've come right out as far as I want to go. Let me just come one more that side there. There's a bit of. And I've come up against the bone there. So that's as far as I'm going to go for me, I think. And then simply cut in. Sometimes this is easier doing this bit with a pair of scissors. Just to go up along there. Again, there's another lovely little fillet. You don't really get a lot of meat on these fish, but the meat that you do get is absolutely superb. Again, I'm going to adjust that. Just feel along the spine and to the other side. And it doesn't matter really, as you can see now, I've changed stance now in the way I'm doing the fish. I'm going from the back to the front. Just makes it easier for me than pushing away with the knife. It doesn't really matter which way you go, as long as you can keep that knife flat as you can to that meat, to those bones. And then just come along. And again, on this side, you can see there's not a lot of meat in that section at all. So I'm going to come across as far as I'm comfortable there. And then again. And across. And again, there's another lovely little fillet of place. Now, that actually looks a little bit of a mess. It looks like I've left loads of meat on there, but genuinely I haven't. You can see there's nothing at all there. Nothing there. There's a tiny little touch there. It's just where I come in with a knife. But I'm quite happy that I've taken all the meat that I want from that fish. That one there now is going to go in the bin. Probably go in a compost depot at the back there. Smell up the pots for a pot for a week. And that is the easiest way to fillet a place. For those that like to have it skinned, I'll show you that now. Right guys, to skin these fish is a pretty simple task. What I've got to help me with this, because my grip isn't what it used to be and I've got no fingernails, so I've got a pair of pliers. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take a fillet, lay it out and just pinch the top, which is the rear end of the fish. You can see there, so I've gripped that. Lay it down nice and flat on a chopping board. I don't want to do this on the cloth. And then simply keep the knife as tight as you can to the chopping board and just come into the fillet and work your way down. Just a little bit of movement on there, back and forward, just to get into that flesh. And if you can keep the knife flat as you can to the board without tipping the blade, which I just did, then there is a skinless, boneless fillet of plaice. Now that dipped in a bit of egg yolk with a bit of salt on it, and then dipped in flour, chucked in a frying pan, or any way you'd like to cook it, really. That's the way I like to cook it. Couple of fillets like that in the frying pan, absolutely stunning. And as you can see, there's not really a lot left on that skin. There's a tiny little frills at the side, which there's nothing onto anyway. I mean, you get little scraggly bits of meat. And again, that's going in the compost heap. Let's move on and do a couple more. So, pliers again, just grab the tip of the fish, the knife in, and just back and forward. And there, all gone. And as you can see, the reason obviously for why I said that you can, when you come towards the outside of the fish, so if I get another one here just to show you, When you come towards the outside of the fish, don't worry too much about trying to get all the flesh and stuff from this side here and from over here, because there's not really a lot there and it'll just sit there. If I can show you on there, there's this little bit down here. The main bulk of the meat is right through the center. So again, perfect little fillet, completely boneless, completely skinless. Do another one just to show you. So I get my pliers, just pinch a tip, and away I go with a knife, just working it back and forward slowly, as flat as I can to the skin of the fish, and away. Here we go. Skin's out, skin's gone. Now that little black section there, it's just the stomach lining, really. Well, it's the internals lining, not the stomach lining, it's the outside. I'll just chop that away. Normally if you've got a bigger fish, you can just scrape that there off. I'm not gonna bother on these little ones. But there we are again. Perfect little fillet. All ready for the frying pan. Well guys, as you can see, I'm back in the fishing shed now. Big mess in front of me. Just trying to work out little bits and pieces to making place rigs, making them a little bit better. Some might work, some might not. You don't know until you give it a go. But I hope you enjoyed the video. I enjoyed the fishing. I enjoyed showing you how to fillet a place to a fashion. if there's any information that anyone needs, honestly, that's what we're doing this for. Me and Will just absolutely love to share the knowledge that we have. Might not be a lot of knowledge, might be a lot of useless knowledge to some, but to others it can be a valuable tool in improving your fishing style, improving your spends, your techniques, your catching. You know, your catch rate might go up, you never know, might go down. But until we try, we don't know, same as anything. So thank you again, lads, for watching. We really do appreciate it, all the support, all the questions, all the nice comments we get. Spot on, lads, well done, you're smashing it, whatever that we get through WhatsApp, Facebook and YouTube. We could do with a few more subscribers on YouTube though, just to boost it a little bit. So if you're not already subscribed, just click over to the YouTube channel when you're watching this video. Should be right underneath. I'm not fancy enough to put a link in, but right underneath the video it'll be our page. If you just click on that page and click subscribe, it doesn't cost a penny, folks. So I would really appreciate if you could. If not, don't worry about it. Carry on watching the videos. It's not a problem. Not a problem at all. But thank you very much for watching. Until the next time, folks. Tight lines. See you on the water's edge sometime.